I sit over to my single leg, where I finish under the single leg to taking his back. Those are the first escape that I generally show from side control, right? If we can't get that, the next thing that I tell us to generally do is, if I can't get the underhook, I'll look to take, get on my side, put my knee inside, re-guard, and go back to my guard position, all right? The next thing that I generally try to show in the regular foundations class, if he starts taking this arm over to attack my arm, I do this stiff arm escape, where I pull my hips back, all right, and I can either stand back up, or I look to get on top, all right? The last thing that I show is if somebody's really, really tight and I can't get an underhook anywhere, I take this hand, I create the back door, I bridge out to my side, and I come to a top headlock position, all right? So those are the escapes that I generally want you thinking rule of thumb, the first ways for me to get out, because all of them except for the getting back to guard is putting me on top, all right? The escapes that we're gonna do today are gonna be attacking from the bottom, and you can finish from the bottom, but a more seasoned guy, what it's gonna do is make you get on top, and maybe you can finish that same submission from top. You're gonna see very briefly what I'm talking about, all right? So what we're gonna do today is, let's say for instance, he's on top of me like this, and most of us have done this before, and his arms are open, right? But I really can't get this underhook, I'm having a hard time. I may push down by his elbow, get my knee inside, all right? From my knee inside, I start locking up this arm, all right? Once I lock up this arm, I want to start attacking with a reverse triangle. This is a low percent submission, but it could be a really good way to escape. So right here, his head is all the way up. I'm gonna push his head down to create space, and I wanna throw my leg to the other side of his head. So all I do is throw my leg to the other side of his head, I lock up my reverse triangle, all right? Now right here, I want you guys, when you're going over this, to try to finish this reverse triangle. The guys with longer legs, like Jack, Kendrick, it's probably gonna work well. Somebody like Stephanie, you're gonna have a hard time finishing this reverse triangle, all right? And that's okay, all right? What we're gonna do is, you're gonna see how this is gonna advance, and at least we're gonna get an escape and get on top, all right? So I want you guys to get to this position, try and finish the reverse triangle. When I do, I grab his elbow if I can, all right, and I squeeze to finish. If I can't grab his elbow, I grab his sleeve. All right, after you do that, I want you to switch. Even for the people who can't get the reverse triangle, you grab his wrist, you tuck here, you have a Kimura lock, all right? Now, what I mean by saying that you shouldn't be able to finish this, he has a way out. His way out right now, I have no leg over his back. He can roll, so I attack his Kimura, he rolls. What just happened? I just got on top. Once I get on top, I can either attack finishing the Kimura, or I just get my underhook and just stay in top side control. So that right there is an escape. I was in side control myself. I used attacks to at least make him roll over and give me a dominant position. If you get these submissions, great. All I care is that at least you're threatening enough to make the guy react. All right? So again, I want you to try to get the submissions when you're working with your partner. If you don't get the submissions, it's okay. Just go along the whole series. So you're going to go in side control over here. Side control over here, my hand's gonna go by his elbow, I'm gonna lift, get my knee inside, start locking this up so that I have his arm. Push down his head, I want it to go all the way by my thigh. My leg's gonna transfer to the other side of his head. I lock up my triangle, reverse triangle. I try to finish, if I can tap, great, if not, I'm gonna move on to my Kimura. Here I lock up, I grab his wrist, I lock up the Kimura. He rolls, as he rolls, all I do is follow. Right, again, from here, maybe I still finish my Kimura. If not, I just get my underhook, take my leg out, cross face, and I hold the side control. All right? So again, I'm not telling you that these are like your go-to escapes. Your go-to escapes are like the ones that I showed in the foundations class that I showed you at first. This is, none of that's working. Now I gotta pull a rabbit out of the hat. All right? So let's grab a partner. I want you to try the reverse triangle setup, switch to the Kimura setup, let the guy roll, and finish in top side control. All right? Let's grab a partner and go on through.